Good day, everyone, and we're here at the last topic for our module in Fundamentals of Information System. And this is chapter 14 in the ebook, but it's our lesson 8, Enterprise and Global Management of Information Technology. Again, our source is from James O'Brien and George Maracas' books, Introduction to Information Systems and Management Information Systems. Now, in managing information technology for the enterprise, so we all know that information technology has a very strong impact in different enterprises, organizations, and businesses. So in managing information technology inside the business, so we have the following areas to consider. So number one is managing business and the IT strategy. So the business strategy must match, or sorry, it's the other way around. The IT strategies must match with the business strategies that the enterprises should have. And the people, the key people involved in managing business and IT strategies are the chief executive officer and the chief information officer. So, trivia lang, chief information officer is the highest IT-related position, okay, na any IT professional can get, or unless mapunta sila as CEO or president ng company. Next, another area is managing application development and technology. So pag na-identify na yung direction ng business in strategizing things and na-identify na din what IT strategies are they are going to take, now pwede na silang bumuo ng mga application development and technological steps or techniques, or in a form of software, or in a form of policies and procedures sa loob ng organization. And with that, we are talking about the CIO, or the Chief Information Officer again, and the Chief Technology Officer, or the CTO. Okay, na magiging responsible or the point people for this area. And lastly, managing the IT organization and infrastructure, it has something to do with the hardware part naman, yung physical arrangement, yung physical requirements and technical requirements ng technology sa kumpanya. Okay, they are being handled naman by the CIO or the Chief Information Officer and the IT managers. Okay, so mapapansin natin in all three areas, the chief information officer has the most responsibility. And tama naman, because having the highest position in terms of information technology, so the CIO has ultimately the say sa mga decisions na meron dito sa mga areas na ito na given. In organizing information technology, so historically daw, an IT was centralized, no? Kasi from different piles of paper and pen na document, okay, kailangan siya na ma-process thoroughly. So with that, dahil hindi pa naman ang uso network, so everything is digitalized using mainframe. So with that, lahat ng documents and lahat ng transactions, okay, nilalagay muna sa isang area, okay, sa isang computer, which is the mainframe computer before. Okay, kaya nagkaroon ng centralization. Now, eventually, dahil sa pag-boom ng network, okay, ng internet, so that centralization ay nag-shift to decentralization. So, from a center mainframe, dinidistribute yung information, okay, into client-server technology. Okay, kaya nagkaroon ng decentralization. But now, nakita nila yung importance both ng centralization and decentralization. That's why hybrid ang approach ngayon. So it's a combination of mainframes and distributed client server. But with the advancement of technology, okay, nag-improve pa yung services or yung technology aspect niyan. So meron na tayong cloud computing ngayon. So instead of saving everything inside the hard drive, ngayon meron na tayong cloud computing and cloud storage, kung saan gagamitin natin yung internet cloud to be the repository of all the process data or yung mga information na nakuha natin. Okay, and in organizing IT, these are the some of the areas or aspects or support group na tumutulong so that we can organize the technology well inside the enterprise. So number one is the Global Alliances Development and Support Group. Okay, so with the advancement of technology, nagkaroon din tayo ng globalization. And globalization means merging of technology, economies. So, nagsama-sama economies natin. Ibig sabihin, hindi naman literally na iisang government na lang tayo, but countries work hand in hand to produce a certain product or services. Okay, kaya malaki yung naging impact ng global alliances. Okay, in organizing information technology, we have several examples like we will discuss later on yung mga classic examples niyan. Next, we have the E-commerce and Supply Chain Management Development and Support Group. Diba na meron ng easy access, easier access, and faster way to communicate sa mga suppliers and partners kung may mga kailangan kang products and services using IT. Next is the Computer or Communication Operations Management Group, wherein, di ba, now, with the pandemic and the advancement na naman ng technology, okay, yung way of communicating is no longer exclusive for face-to-face or personal meeting, yung magkikita kayo in person. Okay, meron na tayong mga online platforms na nag-a-allow ng video call or video conferences to pull off a meeting, a seminar, a webinar, or a training. Okay, next is the marketing and visibility initiatives planning group. Okay, so now the social media is one of the main platforms to advertise and to market your products and services. Gone are the days na flyers ang main, although there are flyers today pa, meron pa mga brochures na available today, but ang pinaka-powerful na marketing strategy is the use of internet or social media. And again, thanks to technology for having them or for developing them. Next, Enterprise Integration Development and Support Group. So sa enterprise integration, yung from different departments and units having different responsibilities, nag-merge na sila, no? Nagkaka-connect na sila sa isa't isa. Okay? And mas madali na yung nagiging transaction from one department to another. Okay? Hindi na kailangan magpasa-pasa ng documents or files using paper, no? Or yung manual way of doing things. So mas mabilis na. And dahil electronic siya, they can send they can send information na to all departments in just one click or one send button. Now, sabi ko nga kanina, speaking of global development or global alliances and development, one of the best examples of globalization in business and in IT is the outsourcing and offshoring aspects ng business. Okay, ano ba yung outsourcing and ano itong offshoring? Okay, they are very similar with each other. Actually, offshoring is an example of outsourcing. So let's define first what outsourcing is. So outsourcing means purchasing products and services that were provided internally. So dati, pinoproduce yung product within the company, but because of certain reasons, of certain valid instances, okay, they chose another partner, a partner agency, a partner company, or another company to partner with para mag-produce ng mga products and services na yon. Ano-ano yung mga reasons? They can save money. They can focus on core competencies. They can achieve staffing levels. They can gain access to global resources and decrease time to market. So say for instance, ang classic example ng outsourcing is the call center. Diba? Yung customer service, yung tech support, instead na sa US lang naka-base, okay, in-outsource ngayon ng mga US companies or in other companies around the world, doon sa mga mas mura yung labor, katulad ng Pilipinas, in India, in China, because kung pagbabasihan yung salary or yung ipapasweldo sa mga Americans na nasa US compared dito sa mga Pilipino na nandito sa Pilipinas, definitely mas malakas or mas malaki yung matitipid nila. Okay, and still getting the same quality since relatively naman okay ang mga Pilipino mag-English. Same true with the Indians and some basically India and Philippines doon. Pero in terms of developing products, 'di ba, yung say for example yung car assembly, no, dati ang kotse, 'di ba, alam natin European cars sa Europe talaga ina-assemble. But ang nangyari ngayon with the globalization and outsourcing, nagkakaroon din ng offshoring. So ibig sabihin, dinadala overseas yung ibang gawain, products and services, again, to save money and to gain access to global resources. Now, halimbawa sa kotse, no, when you come up with ng isang car, say for example, sa Europe pa rin yung pinakakatawan ng kotse, okay, yung gulong pwedeng dinevelop na sa China. Okay, tapos pagdating sa Pilipinas, i-assemble na lang hanggang mabuo. And with that, yung production cost nila mas mababa kaysa kung sa Europe lang or sa US lang or sa Australia lang i-develop yung isang product or service, 'di ba? Kasi dollars ang pinag-uusapan doon tsaka euros, and alam naman natin yung palitan nila is malaki talaga. So that means mataas din yung ipapasweldo nila kung magsistay doon yung labor. But they are, since they are outsourcing and offshoring, in one way or another, they can save money, okay, and makakagain pa rin sila ng same profit, okay, and because there is also an increase or may flexibility na, no, kasi nga worldwide na siya, globally, mga global brands like Coca-Cola or Toyota, okay, so dahil lumalaki yung market nila, so instead na sa Japan pa yung Toyota bibilhin, so nagkakaroon sila ng offices dito sa Pilipinas. Same true with Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola is worldwide known as soft drinks or soda, na hindi lang yung sikat sa Pilipinas or sa US. So across the globe, merong Coca-Cola. And alam naman natin na may pabrika dito ng Coke sa Pilipinas. May pabrika din ng Coca-Cola sa ibang bansa. So dahil nga nag-outsource at na-offshore yung mga yung production, yung operation, mas nagmumura yung labor cost, yung production cost, and at the same time, yung time to market mo, hindi na kailangan gising yung mga Amerikano just to sell their products in the Philippines ng gabi kasi umaga sa atin. Likewise, sa atin naman, di ba, nakaka-focus naman yung Coca-Cola Philippines in marketing here in the Philippines kesa mag-op sila to gain customers sa galing sa US. So, kaya nagba-branch out sila. Okay, next. Yon. So, offshoring means relocating of a firm's business processes to lower cost or location. Okay, example nga yan, yung some companies some parts of the companies are brought in an economy na mas mura. Okay, like sa China, usually sa Asia yon, eh, yung mas mura yung labor and production cost. Okay, and we can see that in business process outsourcing, yung mga IT companies, yung mga call centers, and many more. Okay, karamihan mga IT related products and services yung ino-offer. Okay, and I'll see you again for the second part of our last module.